President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has high hopes the historic multilateral activity in the West Philippine Sea could help Manila counter Beijing's aggression. Sunday's joint drills of the Philippines, the U.S., Australia, and Japan were aimed at enhancing the capabilities of their defense forces in handling maritime tensions. Marcos says his administration is doing its best to ease tensions in the region.
We still continue to talk at the ministerial level, at the sub-ministerial level, at the people-to-people level. Lahat ng maaari natin gawin, ginagawa natin para kausap ang Chinese leadership, ang Beijing, makausap sila na natin masyadong papainitin pa. So pag-usap tayo na mabuti para walang banggaan, walang kanon, walang pagkakanon.
Meanwhile, two Chinese ships were monitored during Sunday's exercises. Beijing earlier claimed it conducted its own combat patrols on the same day the Philippines and its allies performed joint drills.
We noticed the presence of two PLA Navy ships, no? In the distance. Pero wala naman pong ginawa itong mga Navy ships na ito para i-block or hadlangan yung ginagawa nating mga exercises. So tuloy-tuloy naman, naging successful yung ating multinational maritime cooperative activity.
China taking a swipe at the upcoming trilateral summit of the U.S., the Philippines, and Japan. Beijing's foreign ministry says China is against any circles that threaten regional peace and stability. It also slams the U.S., the U.K., and Australia for expanding its security partnership, claiming it is intensifying the arms race in the Asian Pacific region. China's comments come on the heels of the first maritime cooperative activity of the Philippines, the U.S., Japan, and Australia.
We oppose relevant countries cobbling together exclusionary small circles and creating bloc confrontations. Japan in particular should learn from the lessons of history and be cautious in its words and deeds in the field of military security. Any cooperation conducted by any countries should be conducive to regional peace and stability.
Beijing also singled out Washington, saying it firmly opposes the U.S. attempt to deploy a medium-range missile system in the Asia-Pacific region.
We have no interest in competing with any country on military power. China firmly opposes the U.S.'s practice of deploying medium-range missiles in the Asia-Pacific region and strengthening forward deployments at China's doorstep to seek unilateral military advantages. We urge the United States to earnestly respect the security concerns of other countries and stop undermining regional peace and stability.
Vice President Sara Duterte still mum on the West Philippine Sea issue. Duterte was asked about her stand on the issue on the sidelines of an event of the Education Department Monday. Here's how her exchange with reporters went.
No comments. I think comprehensive na yung statement ni Congressman Paulo Duterte about me and the West Philippine Sea. Department of Foreign Affairs and the Secretary of the Department of National Defense.
The Vice President's brother, Davao City Representative Paulo Duterte, issued a statement last month saying it is not the job of the Vice President and the Education Secretary to demonize China or any other country. Vice President Sara Duterte also downplaying a recent poll which placed her as a front-runner in the 2028 presidential elections. The Pulse Asia survey showed Duterte in a statistical tie with Senator Raffy Tulfo as the top choices for president. The Vice President had previously floated the idea of running in the 2025 midterm elections, but she did not specify what position she would seek.
Napakalayo pa kasi
Philippine officials slammed the demand set by fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy in exchange for his surrender. Sherian Torres reports.
Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla rejects the supposed condition set by Kingdom of Jesus Christ leader Apollo Quiboloy, telling the televangelist to just surrender. Aside from the Davao Court's issued arrest warrant for sexual abuse of minors and maltreatment, the DOJ is also awaiting a similar order from the Pasig City Regional Trial Court for qualified trafficking charges against Quiboloy. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says Quiboloy is in no position to make demands.
It seems to me a little bit jail-bagging the dog. Na isang magbibigay ng kondisyon sa gobyerno sa kaso niya kapusado sa wakang dolas. So, I mean, we will exercise all the compassion to Pastor Quiboloy.
Marcos also has this to say about Quiboloy's attempt to link the U.S. government to his cases in the Philippines.
All the proceedings will be fair. Now, as to the involvement of the United States, malayo pa yan. That's going to take years. So I don't think that's something he needs to worry about.
Quiboloy's lawyer, meanwhile, claims his client did not set any conditions and only made requests. That's despite acknowledging that he has not been in direct contact with Quiboloy since the arrest order was issued.
Request. Let's place it in proper perspective. You want to... ang interpretation ng tao, ang presidente, sino ka ba? You are an ordinary citizen. Who are you to give conditions to me? Tama naman yun. Pero wag naman nating kalimutan na lahat po ng citizens ng Republika ng Pilipinas ay pwede pong mag-request sa Pangulo. Gusto naming isabi na yun po ay mula sa kanyang dibdib na i-request niya doon kung pwede lang
kay
President Marcos na baka pwede makonsider na may assurance naman na hindi siya ipasa sa America. United States of America while he is facing the cases in court.
In a recorded voice message aired on Saturday, Quiboloy stated that he will only surrender if the President, Department of Justice, and the National Bureau of Investigation will issue their written guarantees, stating that the Federal Bureau of Investigation, Central Intelligence Agency, and the U.S. Embassy will not interfere in his cases.
Simpleng kaso lang po yan. Napaka-simple. Kung wala po nangingialam ang bansang puti, harapin ko po lahat yan. Napakasimple po ng mga kasong yan. Napakasimple po niyan. Kaya lahat ng ginagawa nila sa Kongreso, sa Senado, puro po yan patibong. O hindi ko alam kung ang $2 million, which is 110 million pesos, nasa kamay na ng mga atat na ito na maging award nila. Kaya atat na atat silang ako ay kanilang madampot, mahuli.
Senator Risa Ontiveros, who led the probe on Quiboloy's alleged abuses of his followers, meanwhile dared Quiboloy to surface.
Umabas ka na sa lungga mo. Total, nagpapa-interview ka naman sa mga vlogger. Magpa-interview ka na rin sa amin sa Senado. Kung totoong matapang ka, ulitin mo lahat ng mga sinabi mo tungkol sa Senado. Dito sa Senado. Make your words of record. Record your shameless audacity in history. Patunayan mo, ganyang pa ring kabastos ang mga salita mo pagkaharap mo na kaming mga senador. Hindi ka namin uurungan.
Vice President and Education Secretary Sara Duterte says it's up to the pastor to face the charges against him.
Maganda yung development na meron ng kaso na nasa tamang forum, nasa tamang venue, nasa loob ng mga korte. Ngayon, kung ano man yung desisyon ni Pastor Quiboloy na gagawin niya, ay personal na niya na desisyon yun.
Police tracker teams are still unable to pinpoint Quiboloy's whereabouts, but they believe Quiboloy is not armed and dangerous despite having more than a dozen firearms registered under his name.
Pwede po ba natin siyang i-consider na armed and dangerous? For now, hindi pa po because wala naman pong indication before na naging marahas po si Pastor Kibuloy at wala naman po tayong na-monitor so far na siya po ay nagme-maintain po ng private arm group o private army.
Sharian Torres, ABS-CBN News.